Hi, I'm Tim. Welcome to our channel, and thanks for logging on. If you enjoyed these videos, do me a favor and subscribe to our YouTube channel right here at Watchbox Reviews. I would really appreciate it, and I promise to update daily. If you like this watch, see it and purchase it on our website, thewatchbox.com. And today we are discussing the Omega Seamaster 300 Master Coaxial, a 41mm Grade 5 titanium diver from a family that bowed at Baselworld 2014 and has been going strong ever since. This is the vintage-inspired Seamaster in the labyrinthine Omega Seamaster family. I'll also say that the timepiece, although 41 millimeters in diameter, is reasonably compact across the wrist. It's more like a 38 or a 40, being only 47.9 millimeters lug to lug. This watch wears easily. It's not a thin watch at 15 millimeters, but nor is it the thickest. For a diver, it's reasonable and it will fit underneath a jacket cuff. The spacing between the links is a contemporary 21 millimeters, so though vintage inspired, this watch does have a modern planted stance and footing on the wrist. The Omega factory strap fitted is a handsome contrast, a honey-colored leather with a lightly contrasting stitch bolstered down the center, calfskin on the underside as well, and a matching Omega titanium clasp. The clasp with twin triggers, so it is quite secure on the wrist, double finished satin and polish for contrast. You will note that there are no minder loops on the strap, and that is because this is a minderless system. You tuck any excess length, once sized, under the clasp, no excess length flapping in the breeze, no minder loops necessary. It is an elegant look, it is a clean aesthetic, and one you will appreciate, as this watch is largely about its aesthetic and mechanical virtues, each one in equal measure. The timepiece talks the talk, but it also walks the walk, reminiscent of the very first Omega Seamaster 300s of the late 1950s. The watch is not as overtly retro as the 2017 Trilogy series, but it does draw heavily on its source material, starting with the relatively straight and minimally beveled lugs. They're squared off at their ends. The side of the case is thin in the fashion of mid-century divers, and it also features a contrast between satin and high polished. This is Grade 5 titanium, so both very light and exceptionally scratch resistant. 6% aluminum and 4% vanadium, 90% titanium. 6-4 is the alternate name for Grade 5 tie. And being vintage-inspired, it does not feature crown guards, and you won't miss them. I've never once needed crown guards to keep my crown and stem tube assembly intact. In general, if your crown gets sheared off while on the wrist, your wrist has been sheared off with it. The timepiece features a bezel that has a satisfying detent, but it is remarkably refined. It's more Rolex Submariner and Blancpain 50 Fathoms, or even Grand Seiko SBGA 229, than it is Doxa Sub or Panerai Luminor Submersible. It's a very refined click, although it is distinct, and it's anything but minimalist. It is tuned, perhaps, to a creamy Cadillac-like quality. The timepiece features plenty of knurling outboard and a polished knurling profile. It features ceramic, so you have a ceramic bezel, robustly scratch-resistant, with liquid metal inlays that are permanently bonded to the blue ceramic. Luminescent pearl, you can line it up with the minute hand, and now you have an impromptu 0 to 60 minute timing device, and I will note that it counts up from 0 to 60, so short of needing to time hours, I find this is actually easier to reference and more useful than a chronograph without the downstream servicing costs. From this angle, you can see to good advantage what makes the dial so special. It's a matte granular quality, almost pebbly, much like a Patek Philippe 5524G, and then there are sunken revetments for solid blocks of ecru-colored simulated patina superluminova. So the watch has that vintage look right down to the hollows of the dial and the quarter Arabics in a vintage font. The timepiece is minimalist. There is no date, but you do get the functionality of the base caliber in that you still retain the time zone functions of the standard automatic coaxial chronometer with a date. Now, this is caliber 8400. It is a master coaxial. We'll discuss what that means. It also features hacking seconds, so you can set the watch precisely. It is a COSC chronometer, but it is more than that, as it features a fully cased-up test in six positions that includes exposure to water, exposure to magnetism, winding efficiency, power reserve. The master chronometer, which includes everything from the anti-magnetic hairspring to the fully cased-up assembly with the dial, is a complete test of a watch's chronometric precision and durability, which is why Omega now tests using that standard, which was developed in conjunction with the Swiss Federal Institute of Metrology. Still a COSC chronometer, but now that and more. Twin mainspring barrels, 60-hour power reserve, 25,200 vibration per hour beat rate. It uses the latest tri-level coaxial system, and if you loop the watch between the winding bridge at center and the balance bridge, you can actually see the elements of the tangential contact escape wheels of the tri-level coaxial. Automatic winding, full balance bridge with a free sprung index for shock resistance, a silicon SI14 hairspring for anti-magnetism, and the watch is effectively amagnetic. 38 jewels, this watch is tough, 300 meters water resistant, aesthetically charming and versatile. It could be your dress watch, it could be your sports watch, it could even be your only watch, and it will fit a broad range of wrists. Rolex doesn't give you this kind of technology in its modern watches, and Breitling is light years behind. Omega's leading the way with new technology in affordable and practical packages. See this one and find out why on the Watch Box. Omega Seamaster 300 Master Coaxial.